the hype of a story like the Aventador, it's tough to keep the pace. But unimaginably, we're upping the pace. Not one supercar, but over 100 of them. The annual Park Supercar Show in Mumbai.
Yeah, Armas, you and me thought of this together, and we just started off as a small event at Kalagoda with 20, 25 cars. But now it's grown to this size where we had to stop at 101 entries. So it's a huge, huge turnout, and it's great. It's been phenomenal. The driver's response and the venue choice has been just outstanding. So I'm actually shocked at the number of people that have come up today. When I came in the morning at 8:30, the place was packed. I was shocked.
And shocking the sight surely was, from luxury brands like the Rolls-Royce to three-wheel street racing machines like the T-Rex, there was everything on display. The Lambos and the Ferraris were drawing oohs and ahs from the crowds, but there was eye candy for every kind of enthusiast, with all the brands being there. And I'm sure Mumbaikars didn't mind missing their Sunday morning sleep for these showstoppers.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind waking up every Sunday for this.
Everyone who loves cars have to be here today because the cars here are really lovely.
You require at least 3 hours to absorb every single car. And if they were here the whole day, I would stay here the whole day and just watch them. This is a special Sunday. My day is made.
Sure, we may not have the ideal conditions to own these kind of exotics, but that's not going to hold back supercar lovers.
I think it's overwhelming, especially this year. I think the response has been absolutely overwhelming. We are increasingly seeing over the number of years that in spite of the infrastructure, people are feeling a lot more confident on investing in these cars. And of course, the arrival of the booth circuit has propelled the entire market forward. So I do see a very, very positive year ahead. And official presence makes a lot of difference.
Upping the prestige of the event was Lamborghini's legendary test driver Valentino Balboni, who flagged off the supercar parade.
We're at the start of the supercar parade, and the lineup in front of us looks absolutely incredible. As you can see, hierarchy has taken place again. Hormuz is driving, I'm just riding. But really eye candy over here.
No, I think it is absolutely fantastic. It's a great feeling. You just can't believe you're in Bombay, actually.
I know, the crowds are going absolutely
I've got
wild.
Only Ferraris and Lamborghinis in front of me, behind me, and then there are all the Porsches, the R8s. It's just unbelievable. In fact, I think this sort of sight would be spectacular anywhere in the world.
Absolutely. And you know what's amazing is this level of enthusiasm even in the crowd, and they're actually behaving themselves so well. Nobody's, hampering the cars.
That's true.
There's a certain amount of respect over here, and it shows, it's just incredible.
I think that way the crowd over here is really, really the best.
Adrenaline levels were very high. Cameras, phones, iPads were all clicking away to grab these hotties forever. And one of the most important experiences of a supercar is its sound. The crowds just didn't want to see them, they wanted to hear them. Serpentine queues of petrol heads greeted the cars as though they were heads of state from their fantasy world. The course of the supercar parade went from the race course to Nariman Point, via Malabar Hill, the Whirly Ceiling, to the domestic airport and back again. And it certainly didn't look like a sleepy Sunday Mumbai morning at all. The supercars even briefly tempted people to try a new faith. Young, old, they were all out on the streets to have a taste of car enthusiasts' nirvana. Shrieking V12s, screaming V10s, roaring V8s, and burbling flat sixes, wowing the crowd. and the level of excitement was pure and unadulterated everywhere we went. Park Supercar Show, despite all the chaos out on the streets, the adrenaline and the madness left everyone in a state of bliss and a high that was hard to break down.
So, Hormuz, I mean, I think this year has gone completely, totally berserk. There were so many people out there
completely on the roads. Completely mental. I think Mumbai came to a standstill, and I think I don't blame them. It's just been the most phenomenal parade of the best eye candy on wheels you can possibly get. And really, I mean, just look at the cars. You were standing between 1, 2, 3, 4 Lamborghinis.
And tons of Ferraris. And, you know, I mean, we were just thinking of the numbers last night. This is like, what?
I think,
how many crores worth of cars?
I think
cars
a quick back of the envelope calculation, maybe about 200 crores worth of cars over here.
And about, 300 BHP on an average with 100 cars.
So I think there's a message to the world. If you think the Indian economy is slowing down, well, this doesn't say it is. It just shows that there's such a passion for cars, especially in the city. And we are just thrilled that, you know, we've been able to give people such a fantastic time. I think just the joy on people's faces. Of course, people are going a little crazy on the streets, but really these cars do something to you, they just go straight for
our
heartstrings.
You know, we had a Jain procession along the way, and I was commenting to Hormuz how they'd forgotten religion. They all had their cameras out and they were looking at the cars, and that's just it, you know. This is a kind of Zen and Nirvana that nobody and nothing else can evoke. It's absolutely mad.
Absolutely, and I think next year it's going to get better. Hopefully, we'll have it even better organized. But I think one thing's for sure is that the Park Supercar Rally or Parade has become an annual fixture, third week of January in the calendar over here. I honestly think it's the next big event in Mumbai after the marathon. And clearly, there's so much interest over here. It's just very, very encouraging.
Well, I'm all for hot cars running around on the road as opposed to the marathoner. So I'm much more for this event. And I'm looking forward to it next year. We hope you've enjoyed watching all of it with us.
Don't go away. Right after this break, Hormuz is going to give you some hot news from the auto industry.